Good morning and welcome back. Today I am back with another video. Today I will tell you about ILSS or idle start stop system. I was going through the forums and found lot of people are complaining that their idle start stop system is not working in their car. So for this I will use my reference car Tata Altroz, and I will tell you why ILSS or idle start stop system sometimes doesn't work in your car. So before going why it doesn't work, I will tell you what is idle start stop system. Idle start stop system is a fuel saving feature, and it stops the car in traffic lights or where the car is stationary under certain preset conditions set by your manufacturer. Now before going through this video, I will tell you what actually controls this particular idle start stop system.
Let me show you how it's working. I am already going to reach a traffic light and the speed is at the desired level. I put on the brakes and bring the car to the neutral, and you can see that the ILSS has started working. The signal turns green and I press the clutch and the car starts again, and I take the car away from the traffic light. Result shows that 30 seconds of stopping time also conserves a good amount of fuel. So this is a very good and interesting feature in a modern car.
Now let me tell you what is actually ILSS system. ILSS system is basically a start stop feature which conserves fuel at traffic lights, and also it saves the environment by cutting off the CO2 emissions. So nowadays we find most of the modern cars are fitted with this particular ILSS system, as this particular system was previously found in expensive cars, but now mainstream cars like Altroz or in this category are being fitted with this system. Now let me tell you how ILSS system works. ILSS system is basically called the idle start stop feature, which is controlled with the help of BMS. Now what is BMS? BMS is actually battery monitoring system module which you find is attached to the negative terminal of your battery. Now this BMS module generally records all the behavior of your battery, its charge, its voltages, its state of charge condition, and based on all this data it controls the ILSS. Now normally in a car the basic function of your battery is to start the car, which is the most primary function of your battery, and the secondary option is your supplying electricity to your electronics and other functions of your car. So remember, the primary function of your battery is to start the car. So when the battery finds that its state of charge is much less than the required charging current required to start the car, it will automatically switch up the ILSS. And there are, let me tell you also, there are some other functions. The ILSS also depends on the ambient temperature when you are driving the car. Suppose the ambient temperature is too high and your air conditioner is running, and under this condition the ILSS will not work, because it will depend on the comfort settings set by your manufacturer, and if it is below that particular comfort setting the ILSS will not work. Again, if the ambient temperature is too cool, so it will have the heater and the blower running, and the heater and blower requires a large amount of current, and under this condition also the ILSS will be switched off. Thirdly, if you have the engine in cold condition, in a cold condition the cranking power required by your engine is much more, so it will require a large amount of current, and under this condition also the ILSS will not work. Again, if your engine is too hot, then your cooling fan the radiator fan will be working in full swing, and under this condition also the ILSS will not work because it requires a large amount of current. So in these conditions the ILSS will not work. Other than this, there are some external condition also where your ILSS will not work. What are these external conditions? All your four doors must be properly closed. Secondly, your boot door must be properly closed, and your bonnet also needs to be properly closed. And you should fasten your seat belts. If you are alone, you should fasten your seat belt. You have a co-passenger, then both of them should fasten your seat belts properly. If all these conditions are also in place, then ILSS will work. Even then, sometimes ILSS doesn't work. And what are maybe the conditions? Let me tell you, in my case, the ILSS suddenly stopped working. In fact, my car was lying idle for the 10 days, and when I took the car for a spin, it didn't work. I took the car for spin for another 10-15 kilometers. Even then, the ILSS didn't work. So I did some do-it-yourself job to make it working. You can also try this. So what is this? Let me tell you. Under these circumstances, you keep your engine idling for around 15 minutes. For around 15 minutes with your headlight on in low beam position. And during this period, do not operate any of your other car electricals. And after 15 minutes of your idling with the car, take the car to a spin for 10 to 15 kilometers, and I think your ILSS will start working. And I did the same thing, and ILSS started working again. And the last procedure is, I will show you, if that particular procedure doesn't work, the last step you can see whether your bonnet switch is working properly. Check it like this, whether it's working properly and this particular wires are properly connected. If there is any loose connection or something like that, so check that. If the first procedure doesn't work, simply open this negative terminal with the help of 10 mm spanner, remove it, wait for 30 seconds and refit this particular terminal. This is the last step for do it yourself. Simply open this, remove it from the terminal and reinstall it and tighten it. And for this you will be requiring a 10 mm ring spanner or a open end spanner. And after refitting it, drive the car for another 30 minutes. Why you should drive the car for another 30 minutes? Because the particular data stored in your BMS will be cleared. So the BMS needs to store the fresh data. For that you need to run the car for at least 30 minutes, and then again check if the ILSS system is working or not. And if after this procedure your ILSS doesn't work, you need to go to your service station and for rectification. So my friends, I have been able to tell you about ILSS system and how it works and what are the things you should follow if your ILSS system doesn't work. So in this way you can easily solve your idle start stop problem, and in 99% of the cases your problem will be solved. And in my case the first procedure solved the problem, and in some cases the second procedure solved most of the problems. So I think in this way you can easily solve your problem before going to a service center, because lot of persons are having service center quite a distance away from their home. So hope I am able to explain this feature to you properly, and please subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Thank you very much and goodbye.